click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will see energy bands in solid. We know solid mainly classified into three parts: conductor, semiconductor and insulator. Now, in case of conductor, we have a free electron that take parts in the conduction process. In insulator, we don't have free electron. So, insulator is not taking part in the conduction process. And semiconductor at low temperature behave like an insulator, and at high temperature, it behave like a conductor. Now, we'll see energy bands in the solid. We know in an atom, there are electrons. An electron present in the valence orbit called as valence electron. Now, when we are talking about isolated atom, that case, we have only one energy level. But when atom comes together in a solid, we have combination of energy level. So, the combination of all valence electron energy level forms a valence band. We'll see what is the definition of valence band. The range of energy level possessed by valence electron is called as valence band. As we know, when we have an isolated atom, means suppose we are taking the example of sodium. Then in that case, we know electronic configuration of sodium is 2, 8 and 1. So, there is one valence electron. This is about the isolated atom. But when we are talking about the sodium as a solid or sodium crystal, that case we have a n number of valence electron. So, in sodium crystal, we have n number of valence electron. Means there are n number of valence electron energy level. For isolated atom, this is isolated atom. We have only one energy level of valence electron. But in sodium crystal, we have n number of valence electron. So they combine their energy level and form a valence band. Let us see what are the properties of valence band. We know in case of insulator, all electrons are tightly bound with the nucleus. Means all the electrons are belonging to the parent nucleus. Hence, valence band is fulfilled. In case of insulator, valence band is fulfilled. In case of semiconductor, suppose we have semiconductor material at low temperature, then valence band is fulfilled. But at high temperature, valence band is partially filled. Means, in case of characteristics of valence band, we have to write valence band is fulfilled or partially filled. Let us talk about conduction band. Now, conduction band is the range of energy level possessed by the conduction electrons. Now, the characteristics of conduction band. We know, in case of insulator, all the electrons are tightly bound with the nucleus. Means, there are no free electrons for the conduction. Means, in case of insulator, conduction band is empty. But, in case of semiconductor, at low temperature, it is empty. But, high temperature, electron will move from valence band to conduction band and it start conduction. Means, in case of semiconductor, it is partially filled. In case of metal also, it is partially filled. Hence, we can say conduction band is empty or partially filled. It is empty or and that is belonging to the higher energy level. So, we'll say the energy level of the conduction band, from this diagram also it is clear, it is at higher energy level. Let us discuss about forbidden band gap. Now, this is the energy band gap. Means, If you want to write down definition, we can say this energy band gap is a separation between top of the valence band and bottom of the conduction band. So we'll write here, separation between, there are no electron present in the forbidden gap. Only electron can jump from valence band to conduction band, that time it cross the forbidden gap. So here we can see no electrons are present in the forbidden gap. Then in case of insulator, forbidden gap is very high. In case of conductor, there is no forbidden gap. And in case of semiconductor, it's very less. In case of silicon, we have 1.1 electron hold. And in case of germanium, we have 0.7 electron holds. In this way, we can define bands in a solid. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and please subscribe Ikeda.